Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Jacobs. I'm a doctor of physical therapy and I'm an inventor of advanced soft tissue release, ASTR specialty. I am a cancer survivor and I used to suffer from chronic migraines, headaches, fatigue, pain after my second cancer treatment, and I was able to help my condition through the discovery of advanced soft tissue release. It's a holistic approach that treats the source of the problem with invention of several instruments. This is some of the instruments. Oh, it's movable. Okay.
So
the goal of this video is to go over current treatments that for chronic pain patients and highlight the most effective treatments based on the studies, and also uncover the 10 elements that I have discovered that relieved my own chronic pain and also helped a lot of my patients to experience chronic pain relief. And hopefully from this video, I actually to challenge healthcare providers to treat the source of the problem instead of symptoms based on research studies. So current modality that used for chronic pain include massage, acupuncture, spine adjustment or mobilization, also stretch, dry needle, manual therapy, which actually showed in a lot of study those are like temporary pain relief. It provides a short-term pain relief. Let's go over a couple of studies that reviewed several studies on those modalities. And one of the study done by the University of Ottawa, Canada, and it's reviewed 270 studies. And their conclusion was the benefit of massage, acupuncture, and spine adjustment treatments were mostly in evidence immediately or shortly after the treatment, but faded with time. Another systematic review done by Mailer looked at the manual therapy use and the exercises to relieve chronic pain and subacute pain. And what they have found that there is high quality evidence suggests greater short-term pain relief than the exercises, the manual therapy, but no long-term difference across multiple outcomes for subacute chronic neck pain with or without cervogenic headache. There's much more studies on dry needle, exercises, stretches, massage, manual therapy that showed it provides short-term pain relief, but there was no promising long-term pain relief. And feel free to contact me. I'll send you a link for all the studies. I'm working with students then doing literature review to compact all those studies in one big one paper, so it will be easier for the reader and healthcare provider to have access to that. That's a work I've been working on for the last 6 years, and we summarized it in one paper, and we'll have it available for everybody to review. It's really frustrating as a chronic pain patient that to learn what I learned in the school and what I was using on my patient provide short-term pain relief, but nothing was geared to chronic pain patient, which really sad, because when we look at the statistics, there is 100 million Americans suffer from chronic pain. But still till now, healthcare provider is using modality that provides short-term pain relief. So okay, before we start to looking at the solution, we need to know what is a problem actually and how our body works, so we will be able to gear the treatment to treat the problem instead of the symptoms. In order to do that, we have to understand the normal healing cycle. So you're going to see on the screen the process of healing. For example, external cut. I'm just going to use external paper cut for visualization to help us to understand how our body heal. This cycle is very complicated. I'm just simplifying it in this video just to get idea about what's going on in the body. So first stage of paper cut is inflammation. So during that stage, there is a swelling, redness, blood starts to rush to that area, pain occur. The second stage is the proliferation stage. And that's when the body starts to build a scar tissue in order to heal. If our body does not build a scar tissue, it's an open wound susceptible for infection. So scar tissue is essential for our survival. During this stage, it's not only scar tissue. There's always fascia restrictions, muscle spasm, trigger points. It's a cascade of events. Last stage is actually the maturation stage, when the body starts to heal, it's actually start to break down the scar tissue and everything clear up, this muscle spasm, the trigger points, and the fascia start to get loose. This process could take days, weeks, months, or years. As we get older, our body ability to break the scar tissue decreases significantly. So I will give you another visualization to know how this happened. So let me go over Tom. For example, Tom had a motor vehicle accident. So when he had the accident, he started to experience neck pain. So I'm going over this process that happened internally, but you can visualize it with the paper cut. So in the first stage, he started to have inflammation, swelling, redness in that area. The second stage is actually his body start to build a scar tissue around the micro tear areas in the muscle. During that event, it start to have like fascia restrictions, he start to have muscle spasm and tightness in his neck, and he start to have trigger points also. So after that happened, he start to slouch forward and adapt a bad habit that lead to poor posture and poor body mechanics. And during this event, he starts to stress out because he's not able to work properly, or he has a lot of discomfort during work, and he has a lot of stress because his car is totaled. And then he starts to not eating the proper diet that will help his body to heal. So his diet was affected too. So when we look at this event or at Tom's accident, there's 10 elements occur with that accident. When you look at the screen, there's inflammations. Start with inflammation, then start to have a scar tissue, fascia restrictions, trigger points, muscle spasm, poor posture, poor body mechanics, sometimes gait problems. And then he starts to have nutrition issue because he's not eating the proper diet, a lot of stress and anxiety that was involved with in this scenario. At the end, there's lifestyle changes that lead to the chronic condition to be continuous. And when I looked at those 10 elements, I realized we need to treat all of these simultaneously. And as a chronic pain patient, if we don't treat those 10 elements simultaneously, it's hard to get a long-term pain relief. From my personal experience, I had to work on all these elements simultaneously. But the problem what I found with current treatment models that when we look at a study, massage for scar tissue or fascia restriction or something like that, or manual therapy, you found that a study showed short term but no long term, which was really frustrating. And that's what led me to actually invent an instrument to treat those issues effectively. And these are some of the instruments that I use to break scar tissue, release fascia restrictions, release trigger points, and working on the muscle spasm. So when I looked at the evidence, at current evidence of treating those 10 elements, that was exactly what matching the biopsychosocial model. And this model was developed by Dr. George Angel in 1977. And his approach of treating chronic condition was based on the bio, which the physical problem, the social problem, and the psychological problem that involved with chronic condition. When we look at this model, it was like looking at to treat a patient ergonomically, medically, treat the posture, soft tissue to release the tightness. It was including also meditation, stress relief classes, nutrition, exercise class, which actually currently a lot of practitioners call it multidiscipline model. That's require patient to go to 4, 5, sometimes 6 practitioner in order to address the problem holistically. Let's look at the studies what presented on that model. So one of the study done by Guzman, it's a systematic review, looked at 10 studies that was for chronic low back pain, and there was 1964 was involved in that study. And what they found, there is a strong evidence suggests that the biopsychosocial model treatment approach was more effective with function improvement compared to non-multidiscipline treatment. This is actually one study. There's ton of studies, and I have the link for those studies on the bottom of this video. Feel free to contact me if you need more studies. There's much more studies showing that the holistic approach, when we treat the problem from all aspects, that actually can lead to chronic pain relief. And that's actually what I utilize through ASTR treatment. So the problem with the multidiscipline model or the biopsychosocial model, patient has to go to several practitioners. So they have to go to like meditation class, nutrition class or nutrition practitioner. They have to go have manual therapy, exercise class, or work with the physical therapist, massage for soft tissue, ergonomic training. So when you look at this, and I was reading a lot of forms, that patient was complaining it's a very time consuming and also it's a very expensive. So you need to block 5-6 hours a week just to treat the source of the problem instead of the symptoms. And that's what led me to reinvent the way we treat patients. So through ASTR treatment, I addressed the 10 elements of the problem simultaneously. And I figured out a way to really address it in 2 to 3 treatments. So most of the patients, when I see them, we address those 10 elements in 2 to 3 treatment. I had to reinvent the manual therapy actually to get a good result in very short term in short period of time. And feel free to check the real treatment videos that I posted on YouTube channel, so you can see the manual part of it. But behind the scene, I actually go over those 10 elements. And I figure out to have protocol for several condition like tension headaches or migraine headaches. I have protocol for that. Fibromyalgia, protocol for that. Sciatica, back pain. Those protocols I developed through in the period of over 6 years, based on the fastest, most efficient way to relieve pain. And so far, these are really working very well for the patient. And I'm constantly working on new, more protocol, or if I found a better way of getting patient better, I actually update those protocol, and I teach it in my classes to the healthcare providers, and constantly work on a new invention, new instrument. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. You will get updates about helpful tips and tricks on how to relieve pain. Also, there is over 150 videos that for ASTR treatment, real ASTR treatment. You can actually see the instrument that I invented and the result I get with my patient. Also, if you are a healthcare provider and you are interested to be ASTR licensed provider, feel free to click the link below to register for next class. I also included the link for my TEDx talks that I shared how I discover ASTR treatment. See you soon.